everybody, here we go with the Wilderness Logic Snipe Hammock. That there is a single layer ripstop nylon hammock that holds 225 pounds. That's their rating. It comes with tree straps, whoopee slings, a stuff sack, and this hammock is about 12 inches longer than your average hammock.
A little bit bigger than an Algene bottle.
Snipe in the house! What I find really cool about the Snipe Hammock is it has an adjustable draw cord on the head and foot end so that you can kind of make yourself a little pouch to improve your lay or to keep your top quilt in or just to be cool or just to have something to fiddle with. It has some shock cord through this little area from right there to right here. Like if my feet were in here, that's a little floppy right now. I can tighten these up, make yourself a little head or foot box. There's one on each end. Now I kind of put that in there and that's drawn up a little bit. Pretty handy feature. Got one at the head, got one at the end. And it keeps these sidewalls nice and tight on you. Now I'm gonna lay myself right on in here. Now see on this draw cord end here, I've got it drawn up a little bit. I'm gonna release both of them. And you see it's a little bit floppier right there. Could flop on you. Depends on how diagonal you lay in here. But if I tighten that up, zip and zap. That changes that, gives me a nice little head box, and you can see on my foot end, I got that one drawn in, and boy, this is a comfortable hammock. You got plenty of room to put your leg up in that position. Some of you people that are side sleepers, I'm not, but I don't know how y'all lay. You got something like this, but this feels very comfortable.
I'll give you a little snot point of view here.
Because nobody looks good laying in a hammock. But you sure do feel good.
So I am laying, man, nice and flat in here.
That's about as flat as I can lay. Let's look at it from the side.
Feels pretty flat if you know where I'm at. Now here's the deal. I'm a guy that lays with my head to the right, feet to the left. A lot of people, seems like most people, like to sleep the other way. So with this pouch here, all you do is just kind of flip the hammock inside out. Like that. Which is probably how most people do it. And in you go. Now the Snipe is just a gathered end hammock, open top. There's no bug netting on it. Although Wilderness Logic sells all the accessories for hammocks. Anything you need. In fact, they also have the Night Owl hammock and the Light Owl hammock. One is made of 1.5 ripstop nylon. It's a double, so you can slide your pad in between. That's the Night Owl. It'll hold a fella or a woman up to 375 pounds. And they have the Light Owl, which is a 1.1 ripstop nylon, double layer, so you can put your pad in, and it's got a rating of up to 250 pounds. Included with your Snipe hammock is a set of tree straps right there. We call them tree huggers.
I love you, shag bark hickory, I love you.
Each one is 6 feet long. I believe that's 72 inches for you inch people. You know, it comes in this little double-ended stuff sack right here, so you can reach inside when you're ready to hang. Grab one of your ends. There is your whoopee sling right on the end, ready to go. They come with these 72 inch long whoopee slings right there. So that's a 6 foot whoopee sling. Now I've got this hooked up with the tree strap doubled up there on a carabiner. There's the whoopee sling going right onto the carabiner. That little bead is just so the whoopee doesn't get sucked inside of itself, because all of this part where my finger is running is called the berry, where the other line goes in, and that's where you get your adjustability. But it does come with these whoopee slings. If you're not familiar with them, you stretch it out like this, and I could take that whoopee way back. When I want to adjust it up, I actually pull this one end up through this berry here. This is sort of like those finger handcuffs you use when you was a kid. You put two fingers in them, and when you tighten it, you can't pull them apart. Same deal. And that's how you adjust your hammock up. Make sure to milk your berry. Milk your berry. Milk your berry. Now what I like to do is I like to put a ridge line on my hammock for hanging stuff, and it gives me this little set of sag I like better. But I gotta tell you, on this hammock, it's comfortable with or without it. What I'm using on mine is a line called Zing It. But I've used paracord on them. You don't want that ridge line so tight that it's like an E string on a guitar, you know. I've got 107 inches right through here. And that just shortens my hammock up a little bit, but I've tested it with my tarps, and this hammock, you know, you've got your tarp still out over your whoopee sling here. I'll probably add some continual loops and some Dutch beaners or something on there and trick this thing out just a little bit, but it's pretty ready to go as it comes. Really comfortable hammock. I've slept one night in it so far. A lot of people talk about getting calf pressure, where there's a little ridge line that can happen in here. Hello. And it doesn't seem to happen much in this, and I think that's due to that extra length on that hammock. You get the Snipe hammock, you get the whoopee slings attached, and you get this set of tree straps for $100, free shipping in the USA from Wilderness Logics. Hey, that's an excellent deal, isn't it? So I'm going to sign off now with a Whooooo Buddy and an all secure in Sector 7. Woo hee ha! Hey!
Beamer on.
Slicky. If you say it long enough, it sounds good. Hey, Precious. Does that look flat to you? Do I look? So. Alrighty then, the Snipe. Now that Snipe hammock. I'm gonna spend a good night in my Snipe, hanging out in the wilderness, because the woods are a delight.